I lived in Barbados. So I served in Grenada for about 10 months. And then I went to Barbados and I served there for 3 or 4. And it was pretty interesting because Barbados, Grenada, and other islands like St. Vincent and Trinidad are all very similar, but Barbados is kind of out here a little bit different than the rest. Their accent is a lot different. After going from Grenada, I had a really hard time understanding what they were saying in Barbados. A lot more heavily influenced by like English or Scottish accents. It's a lot better off. It's a lot wealthier than Grenada was, and they really like eating fish. Tons and tons of it. Whereas in Grenada, they ate mostly just like curried chicken or stewed chicken and the stuff called oil down. Something that was cool about Barbados, the people were just so funny there. Tons of Jehovah's Witnesses. Tons. So always made contacting really, really interesting. And you don't knock on people's doors, you call in. And so you just call in and you'd say good day inside, and they'd come out and talk to you on the street and stuff. It was a pretty interesting place. And the church there are just these three small branches organized into a district. And most of the people were converted in England and then moved back. Because lots of Bajans, they get to like their 20s and then they move to England or to the States. And then once they've made a lot of money, they come back and retire to Barbados. And so it was the only branch I served in where just 95% of them were 50 or over. It was pretty funny. But it was a really good place.
So Barbados, another wonderful place with one of the things that all the West Indies islands, at least the ones I served in, and from talking to the other missionaries, seems to be the same thing as the best people you'll ever meet and the best food you'll ever eat. And in Barbados, they have a lot of flying fish. Flying fish is a very big food that's there, and you'd find a lot of places that would fry flying fish and. And it's fantastic. Fantastic food that they prepare down there. Lots of food places everywhere. You can go down the street. There's food everywhere. And dominoes was a big popular game down there. So not stacking them up and knocking them down, but there's actually the actual game of dominoes, which I guess is kind of you create this this little chain of matching up different dominoes. And so you could hear from blocks away people playing it because when they're getting ready to put down their domino, they would psh, smack it down and put it in order. And that's psh. So you hear this smack down, and there's a few missionaries that got really good at dominoes and would walk down and we'd start talking to them, and they'd be like, "Nah, we're playing a game. We don't want to talk to the missionaries." So we'd say things like, "Well, what if we beat you at dominoes? Then will you talk to us?" And that would do it. So some missionaries would beat these guys. These guys have been playing since they were kids, but some of the missionaries were good. Most of us could not beat them. Most of us were not very good at it. I was not very good at it. But they enjoyed playing with us anyway. And even when we'd challenge them and we'd lose, they would, "Let's hear what you have. You guys are funny guys." And then when we play with them. But notice that I haven't talked about the beaches, because you can't go to the beaches, obviously, while you're a missionary. But you will pass the beaches, and you will see the water and the beautiful beaches, but you can't go. If you do go to Barbados, one thing that we did, and we got permission from our mission president to do it, we got permission from somebody to do it, and we didn't just do it. But you have your area, and any mission you go to, from what I understand, you kind of have to stay within your boundaries. And anytime you go outside your boundaries, there's extended extenuating circumstances. Well, Barbados, if you look up the how big it is, it's a pretty small island. So, but what we wanted to do, we wanted to ride our bikes from one end to the other end, and then and back to our apartment. And we did that. It was amazing. It was so amazing. We saw every landscape of Barbados possible, all the different geographical looks that the country can offer. All the way to the end of the island, there's a big cliff, and then you just see the ocean far away. I think it was a field, if I remember correctly, a big field, and then just a cliff. It wasn't a beach. And then the tip of the island, the other tip, and probably maybe 3/4 of the rest of the island is probably beaches. But at the far north end, where we were at least, where we rode our bikes to, it was just a nice empty cliff. It was kind of like you came to the end of the world, and then had to go back. We spent a little time there. I think we had a lunch or whatever, and came back. And it was during our P day, But if you can get your mission president to approve that, definitely a great experience that I'll never forget is my bike ride across Barbados and back.